Hi there. Today is the video of clearing pain, shock, panic, trauma, frozen energies of the sense of touch and intimacy. Ja, lekker, hè? And most people think of, you know, like shock, being hit or getting an accident. But in the old days, like I hope it is, it belongs in the old days and not in current days. Well, at least not in normal life. Torture was also used on the sense of touch, and not only within on the skin. What about pouring in hot liquids through the esophagus into the stomach? Shock can be caused there also. What about rape? That can be shocking. That's also touch and intimacy. That also can cause a lot of behavioral problematic patterns. So why don't we set up the healing space? Like usual, I like to work in a protective space, because you never know what you encounter. Because the work will be processed in the spiritual plane, the mental plane, astral plane, etheric plane. It will cleanse out stuff in the aura, it will cleanse out stuff in the chakras, it will cleanse out stuff in the organs. Though we focus on the sense of touch and intimacy. And of course, when you focus on that, you also focus on the skin. But what about the lungs? The lungs being touched by air, when you go into a sauna, you know how it feels. Then you, the air is really hot. When you go to a sweat lodge, it's even hotter. That's my personal experience. And that can be pleasant, but it can also be too hot, bringing up a little bit of panic. If you didn't process that, it's now time to do so. So it's time to call in your spiritual support team. If you don't know who your spiritual support team is, you can assume, when it's okay for you, that you will call in your head guide and your holy guardian angel. I am going to call in my spiritual support team. And today is a guided session. I will talk all the time. I mean, even though I am talking, a lot of shifts will occur. And this is the way it's set up. This is part of my life assignment. And before we continue setting up the healing space, I would like to ask from you, do you suffer at the moment from results of unprocessed shock and trauma? Are you even aware of it, that you have it? If you are not aware, there are so many possibilities, I just cannot name them all. You just have to sense of, hey, I like Helen, I'm going to stay, I'm going to tune in, and I'm going to spend an hour of my time with Helen and her healing agencies, and let's see if something shifts. Clearing shock and trauma often brings up a lot of cold energies, so you can cover yourself up with a blanket, but it doesn't help really, because the cold comes from within, it wants to go out. And you just make yourself comfortable, take a seat on your own couch. And take a few deep breaths in. And out. And as you know, you are allowed to make noise when you breathe. When you're doing key breathing or deep breathing, you massage your internal organs. which will allow it and makes it more easier for stuck emotions to be freed up out of the organs. So if you're still there, that's nice. Let's tune in and let's spend an hour or so together clearing out all forms of pain, panic, shock, trauma, frozen energies out of the sense of touch and intimacy. And let's welcome ourselves here. Let's be grounded, aligned and centered. Let's be one with the higher self, subconscious self, as higher self. Let's merge and create a state of unity between our conscious and subconscious selves. And the subconscious selves will accept a state of unity. As higher self, let's merge and create a connection with the higher self, the planet. Higher self, the moon. Higher self, the sun. Higher self, the cosmos. And let's reset the grounding to total present time. Grounded and connected to the center of the planet. And for those who like, can extend their grounding to the center of the galaxy. And let's call in our healing agencies, guides, spirits, energies that will be of greatest benefit in this healing. And let us pray that this experience benefit each of us in spiritual growth, healing and awareness. Let's create a magical circle so that whatever happens within is protected and confidential. And the healing agencies will make sure that for each viewer, an individual healing space will be created. The law of unity will create a unity for this video, for all viewers. And it will also be done in a way that the moment you click away this video, you will step out of the unity. There will be no level of mergers and meldings, no contracts, no agreements, clean breakup, so to say. And let's call in the healing agencies, ask them to create and to call in the magical tool chests for me and also for each individual viewer. And the healing agencies always create several reading spaces for me just next to the camera so I can see how the viewers are doing. And of course I look with my inner eyes, not with my physical eyes. With my physical eyes I see a GoPro. With my inner eye I see about 17 healing spaces, and I always trust my healing agencies. They do know why they create that many. That's fine. Sometimes the core of the healing space is like a topic, a core wounds, and sometimes it is depending on the level of spiritual development on the soul level and the personality level. And for now, we are going to call in the magical lantern so that we open to the higher awareness and enlightenment. And let's now meditate on divine guidance, perfect self, for the next hour. Let's now meditate on the neutral perfect self for the next 45 minutes. And let's meditate on the divine wisdom perfect self for the next hour. So if you like, you can open your eyes or close your eyes, sit up straight, lay down on the couch, whatever you prefer. And if you are a returning viewer, you know I always like to use a few tools together with my healing agencies. And on the spiritual plane, mental plane, astral plane, etheric plane, they are being created just in front of me on the desk. For those who are highly psychic, they can see it already. They can see the incarnational string from your soul. All past life, all incarnations are being lit up. An event-based spiral is being created, and in this case, events where shock and trauma and panic are occurring in your current lifetime, causing a shock on the sense of touch. I always see here a line, four lines in fact, but they're all together. And they start 3 years before birth and 3 months into the future. And on this side there emerges a tree. That is your family tree. And between the last video and this video, I've been reading a book. It's a great book in Dutch from Els Stein. De Fontein, so to say, the fountain. And since I read that book, I always see now the family tree, not only as a tree, but also like a kind of fountain, the way she describes in her family system book. It's really pleasant. It shifted. It got another quality, so to say. So I look forward for the first time to tape this on video. This is my cat. She always likes to be on video. It's rarely that she doesn't appear. Amazing. She came into my life 6 months ago. Yeah. Sometimes she's at the other side of the house with my son, and sometimes she's just here. And the healing agencies are spending time on grounding to become aware of our spirit stepping into etheric body. That's the body where also the chakras reside. And ground from there to the center of the planet. A lot of stuff is already shifting. Hearing the cat licking makes me realize that so many senses are interconnected with each other. And I don't know why, but to me, for example, hearing the skin burn, smelling the skin burn, and feeling the skin burn is pretty intense. And in my case, it's not from this lifetime. As you see, I have a good skin, but I do know that I got burned in a previous incarnation, and I see one healing space being lit up. So one healing space of viewers who got burned in past lives or in this life, causing a lot of shock, panic on several senses. The healing agencies will take care that the shock will be processed properly. With processing properly, it does mean it's not being pushed down, it's being processed. It's like having the right to be there, and then to transform, let go of the shock, the panic, the pain, so it can transform and be processed out of the space. Request angels for high magic to connect us with the angelic formators of intimacy and touch. And request angels for high magic to create a symbol of us. And I ask the angels to work on the symbol. The symbol. And why don't we create a kind of statue representing our shock and trauma on the sense of touch? It will appear here. It's like a mini you. And don't worry, we work with developed healing agencies, so they will not mix up any persons. And don't forget, you will not appear in the mini you version here in my desk, but you will appear in front of you. So a mini you will be created for the time being for the purpose of this healing, and then it will be dissolved again. It will be set into concentric circles, so it has its own space. It will be connected to the center of the planet. And only shock and trauma, pain, hysteric energies will be worked upon on the sense of touch and intimacy. And I see my incarnational string being lit up. And for the first time I see that the healing agencies create a incarnational string like a symbol for all viewers. An event space spiral for all viewers, a timeline for all viewers, and a family tree for all viewers. And finally, they start with the family tree. They always do their own thing, don't they? So what they are doing is realigning each viewer, giving them their proper place in their own life system, in their family system. Because from that place you can heal quicker, easier. So for those who it is permitted, let's do that. And let's focus on this lifetime, clearing out the pain, panic, hysteric energies, shock, frozen energies, and trauma on the sense of touch and intimacy on an event space spiral base. We do percentages, let's say 10% at a time, or 5%, so 20 steps. And sometimes the pain, panic, shock, frozen energies and trauma will be more intense than in another step. But because we are working on a symbol, like a mini you, it will not bother your other bodily systems so intense at the moment. So we are transforming the charge on the sense of touch and intimacy to And of course, almost everyone has ever experienced shock during either pregnancy or birth. Perhaps you were being kicked in the belly for some reason. Perhaps your mom was pregnant and got physical abused. She got into a car accident. She got into a crowded scene where she got pushed, and you felt the shock of your mother, and that's being cleared and processed out. Then being born. One person is born smoothly, and another one is born traumatic. So let's clear out that shock. And any other shock which will come along your lifetime. If you have a notebook with you, you can choose to write it down. Or like some viewers, just fall asleep. That's fine too. 3. And for one person, a shock on the sense of touch and intimacy is physical abuse by a parent. It can be being attacked by a dog or another animal which shook you up. It can be that you got into an accident of any kind. Car accident, train, bus, bike, stair accident, or whatever you can come up with. Scooter accident, scootmobile. Reminds me of a funny scene in a Mr. Bean movie. I don't know why. Going down a steep mountain. Perhaps you as a baby were being thrown into something to prevent you from harm. But you didn't realize that at the time, and you got shocked, you got frozen, which prevented you for the rest of your lifetime to be intimate with loved ones later. So let's clear out that shock. 4. And of course, what I'm telling is not chronological. 5, 6, and I'm going to call in extra healing agencies. I work for many, many years already with a team. It's almost a twin, but it's not a twin. It's the one is an angel and the other is a healing agency. The angel clears out all death energies, and then immediately, without any void, the other, the healing agencies, fills in with life energies. So the angel pulls out death energy. Death energy can be from this life or previous lifetime. It can be foreign energies. It will be pulled out. And without a void, life force, life energies of you will be filled in. I think we are at 6. 7. Eight. Nine. Twelve. 13. 14. 14. And of course, the senses are often intertwined, meaning if you got blasted by a bomb in a previous lifetime, the shock can be on your sense of sight, on your sense of touch, and on your sense of hearing, also on the sense of balance, which will be processed in a later video, sense of balance. For now, we are going to clear out the sense of touch. And if there is any connection between shock on another sense, it will be cleared out also. So you don't have to watch all the videos in a row. I would not advise to do that. Fifteen. 16. 16. And if you faced physical abuse in this lifetime, you might see memories flashing before your eyes, the panic, the shock, the rage can come up, but also the sadness of boundaries being crossed. And what I also see is that the angels of forgiveness are entering our space. And for those of the viewers who are ready to receive a ritual of mutual forgiveness of the victim and the perpetrator, receiving both forgiveness for being the trigger and for being the endurer of the act. 18. And this also triggers the ladies of Dharma who like to work with me. I work with the ladies of Dharma since I live in Switzerland, in this house. And these beings of light offer a lot of grace for all viewers. And for them, time is irrelevant, space is irrelevant. So wherever you are watching this video, the ladies of Dharma recognize you and offer you support wherever they can, on a personal level, life level, family system level, and on a soul level. devil. And I'm going to ask for 7 nights of dream state healing to continue with this event-based spiral healing, to be brought to its fullest completion in alignment with your personal process, your personal karma, and your highest part of destiny. And I see that this work will be performed in the high magic temples in the high astral planes, and it will be connected to a certain force. I will write down the name of the force. I cannot come up with the name at the moment. And what I also see is that in the dream state healing, a lot of viewers, their astral body will be cleansed of pain, panic, shock and trauma in the astral plane. Because also shock can really interfere in that plane, making you vulnerable for all kinds of undesirable encounters. And it will be also paid attention to, will be brought to its fullest level of karma completion. And there will be several types of healing agencies assisting all the viewers. And let's call down the divine descending force. Yeah, let's now focus on the past life excarnation moments, meaning moments of dying tied to shock and trauma residues on the sense of touch and intimacy. That might be that you were shot to death, crashed to death, or sliced to death, or whatever happened, and strangled to death if you had any memories of that still carrying with you. They might be hidden within your physical body, causing you all kinds of pains, And my healing agency just pointed out it's now time to clear that out. And like I said, there is this this healing duo, this angelic being clearing out dead energies, and this celestial being filling up with life force. And they always work from out a evocation triangle. Why is that? Because the vibration of those two beings, the angelic being and the celestial being, is so different than our human vibration, that we always place them in a evocation triangle, so they are really energetically separated from us and still being able to work for us and to assist us in transforming stuff which bothers us in a subconscious way. And we are going through the timeline. And they are bringing in a few other healing agencies. There is extra protective space being set up. There's more light being brought into the healing space. The moment more light is being brought in, more wounds and shadows will be lit up, will become visible, and what is visible can be processed. A deepening of the grounding with the center of the planet is occurring. And they will also spend time on healing your relationship with the center of the planet, because the planet is who offers life to all of us. We all have a relationship with the planet, with nature. It is inevitable. It will be healed and cleared of any false information, black magical influences. So you will receive a connection from out the planet, the center of the planet, the core being, which is pretty, pretty old. And she is the one connecting with you. So we don't have to bother think how it's done. We just have to be aware of our physical body, of our internal space, and to feel how we are grounding. Because it's nice to be fully embodied, to be fully grounded when doing this type of work. And the main focus will be sense of touch and intimacy. And depending on your needs, healing agencies will pop up in your space. And you might notice them, you might know it, you might feel them, you might hear them or see them. Or none of the just mentioned, that's fine too. But you will have to trust that you are being assisted right now, completely attuned to what you need today. And we're going to do counting the steps from this lifetime, 3 years before birth, 3 months into the future. We will also do it in percentages, steps of 5%. So our mind cannot interfere too much. And there will be a clearing of any pain, panic, shock, trauma, frozen energies of the senses of touch and intimacy. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 13. 14. 16. 17. 18. 19. 20. And we are continuing with the incarnational string. The angels will identify the top 20 where you have been bothered by pain, panic, hysteric energies, shock, frozen energies, trauma on the senses of touch and intimacy and all the related senses. And it will be cleared out on an incarnational string. And we will start with the less traumatic lifetime. And lifetime number one will be the most traumatic, but we work our way up. It will not be chronological in incarnation, like in time, but it will be in intensity of the core problem. 20. 19. 18. 17. 16. 15. 14. 13. 12. 11. 10. 9. 8. 7. And if you need more time, you just can hit the pause button. And otherwise, you have to trust that in during dream state healing of the coming 7 nights, they will take all the time they need in the high magic healing temples to process all this, this stuff on the sense of touch. 6. 5, 4, And if images of past life flash in front of your eyes, just observe them, let them go. It might help you understand why you have issues with this sense. Four. Three. And the more we count up, the more intense the charge is in these lifetimes. And we are in a safe environment to process it. Two. And the one life carrying the most burden is number one. So it might not be the core life, it might not be the trigger life. It is just a life carrying the most, the highest level of burden on the sense of touch and intimacy. And for those who are hearing stuff, they also might hear the angelic choir singing, supporting the angelic formations of touch and intimacy. And this is really important episode, because the quality of processing the shock and trauma on this sense can influence your relationship, or at least the quality of the relationships you have with the people around you, but also not only those close to you, but also those further away. And seamlessly go to the Tree of Life, the fountain. And why not also do 20 generations here, so we keep counting 20. First generation will be your parents, and then it just expands out. Grandparents, great-grandparents, etc., etc. And while doing it, I will also observe clearing of pain, panic, shock and trauma in the family lines, but also that everybody is able to take in their appropriate place in the fountain, in the system. And I have some healing agencies supporting this work. One. Two. Three, four, five, six, and see a lot of family files being dissolved, being ended. They are no longer necessary. They were appropriate for a few generations, that's it. Six. Seven. It might be that if one of your ancestors got into a accident, severely messing up their physical body, and if that family member was not able to process it or accept any help from the family, it could cause a shock on the family level, and that influences the way down to you, and that will be cleared also. Great. And I see a few viewers who have quite the abuse in their family line. There's a lot of frozen energies tripping off. And be aware that the healing agencies will also make sure that all those stuck and frozen aspects of your ancestors, and they will be assisted to grow up to total present time. So not only your ancestors benefit from it, but also all those ancestors reincarnated new again. And so all those new incarnations are also benefiting from this. I don't know where I was with counting. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. At least in my family system, someone in the 13th generation got hung. Wow. I just see the images, the pictures. I see it all running through the tree and how it froze so many ancestors, so many of the family. It's being cleared right now. Perhaps you as a viewer are matching and receiving the benefits of transformation also. And what's interesting is that I see healing agencies also looking into the family history. What happened before that that moment someone got hung? What happened in the family line that this could occur? What happened in that person's incarnational strength that could occur? And they are really like working on a synergetic level, clearing it all out, completing the karma, providing grace wherever possible. This is this a level of consciousness the high magician Frans Baarden like to work with, which is now pouring in into the family tree. I will write down what it is. 16, 17, Divine Providence, 18, 19, 20, 20th generation. We're going to look back now again from the outer leaves. We go back and again, also making sure that the healing agencies who are qualified and allowed to assist ancestors to take in their appropriate ownership, their place in the fountain. So the mother is the mother, the child is the child. And there's a lot of shifting going on. And we're going to count back. 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12. I see also a lot of shock being processed around birth. I've got counting again. 5, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. And for myself and for about 78% of the viewers, I see a cosmic hall of justice appear, offering justice on the events causing pain, shock, and trauma, on the sense of the sense of touch and intimacy. Because we are in a time that it will become more and more important to be able to feel comfortable touching each other again, not in an inappropriate way, but in an appropriate way, like handshake, etc. So there will be also a lot of clearing out of betrayal on all levels. And let's not forget, we are living interesting times, having the opportunity to clear out a lot of rubbish and false belief systems. And why not? Let's do that. 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, grandparents, 1, parents, and back to us. And for those who have children and grandchildren, great-grandchildren, we ask permission to divine providence to proceed and also provide healing for our children. Grandchildren, great grandchildren, and back to us, grandchildren, children, and back to us. So, how do you feel? I do realize I missed a lot of information of all the information being given to me over the last couple of days, but I'm pretty sure you can think for yourself, have your own insights, and this process will continue for at least another week. Allow stuff to be processed out. Be aware that if you get triggered, It might be like me, I have been triggered a few days before recording this video. It might be that you will be triggered in the coming days, I don't know. Just know that it's time to release. And let's imagine a nice big golden sun above our head. And call back all the energies, release them made available to space, place and time, but it has been released during this healing, during any other time, in the spiritual plane, mental plane, astral plane, etheric plane. Allow these energies to be called back into the nice big golden sun above our head. Allow it to be raised to its highest creative vibration, purified, calling divine joy, divine truth, divine wisdom, divine joy, divine health. And allow these energies to flow down, filling up our seventh chakra, flowing down, filling up our sixth chakra, flowing down, filling up our throat chakra, flowing down, filling up our heart chakra, flowing down, filling up the third chakra, flowing down, filling up the second chakra, flowing down, filling up the first chakra, and expand out, filling up the whole flesh body, which is us. Expanding out, filling up the aura layer in front of us, right of us, behind us, left of us, above us, below us. And call in law of microcosm, macrocosm, so it fills up the astral body, mental body, spiritual body. And how are you? I look forward to the benefits of this healing. I don't know what they are yet. I don't know yet what they will be. I can't imagine, but reality will show. I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next video, we will provide healing on the sense of balance. And yeah. If you have any questions, you can for those who have my personal number, they can contact me. If not, you can always leave a comment down below. Please leave a like for the video. If you know somebody who can benefit from this healing for any reasons, please forward the video, subscribe to the channel, and yeah. I hope to see you next time during the video healing shock on the sense of balance. Amazing. Is dat lekker, hè? Ga je doen? No. I hope to see you next time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching me and Kat. Thank you for putting your trust and spending time with me. And I thank also your spiritual support team. Thank you guys. All of you. And bye bye.